In the last class, we have derived the value of gamma 1 by 2. Gamma half is equal to root pi, we proved it. Let us see some applications of gamma function. Let us see. Evaluate, this is the problem. Evaluate integral 0 to infinity x power 4 e power minus x dx. So, compare this with gamma function. What is gamma function? Gamma n is equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus x, x power n minus 1 dx. So comparing which? E power minus x dx, x power n minus 1, in place of n minus 1 you have 4. That means that is 5 minus 1 or n is equal to 5. This is 5 minus 1 or n is equal to 5. Therefore, integral 0 to infinity e power minus x, 5 minus 1 dx. This integral can be written as 0 to infinity e power minus x, x power 4 can be written as 5 minus 1 dx. So, this is gamma function. In place of n, you have 5 here. Therefore, the value of this integral is, by comparing with gamma function, in place you have, in place of n, you have 5. Therefore, the overall, the value of this integral is gamma 5. So, gamma 5 can be written as 5 minus 1 into gamma 5 minus 1 or directly 5 minus 1 factorial. 5 minus 1 factorial is nothing but 4 factorial, which is 24. So, this is the value of this integral. To evaluate this integral, we made use of gamma function. Right? Let us see another problem. Evaluate 0 to infinity x square e power minus x square dx. This is not a direct gamma function. Here we have a direct gamma function, but here you have x square e power minus x square like that. So we need to take some substitutions. Let us take x square equal to t. Take x square. Why? Because we need e power minus x or e power minus z or e power minus t like that. Therefore, put x square equal to t. X is equal to t power 1 by 2. As x square equal to t, x is equal to t power 1 by 2. In 2x dx is equal to dt. And dx is dt by 2x. That means dt by 2 root t. Dt by 2x. Dx is dt by 2x, but x is t power 1 by 2, therefore dx is dt by 2 root t. Let us see the limits. These are the limits for x. X is from 0 to infinity. As x is 0, t tends to 0. As x tends to 0, t tends to 0. As x tends to infinity, t tends to infinity. So, t is also from 0 to infinity. Therefore, the integral 0 to infinity e power x square to the power of minus x square dx is equal to, in place of x square you have t, and e to the power of minus t square means e power minus t, instead of dx you have dt by 2 root t. T e power minus t dt by 2 root t, simplifying which 1 by 2 is taken out of the integral, 1 by 2 0 to infinity. This is e power minus t, t by root t. In the numerator we have t, the denominator root t. Therefore, finally we have root t in the numerator. 1 by 2, 0 to infinity, e power minus t into root t, dt. Root t is nothing but t to the power of 1 by 2. T to the power of 1 by 2 can be written as 1 by 2 into 0 to infinity, e power minus t. In place of 1 by 2, I wrote 3 by 2 minus 1, which is nothing but 1 by 2, 3 by 2 minus 1. Why I wrote like this, 3 by 2 minus 1, this should be in the form of n minus 1, e power minus x, x to the power of n minus 1 dx. Otherwise, e power minus t, t to the power of n minus 1 dt, that should be the gamma function. Therefore, in place of 1 by 2, I have written 3 by 2 minus 1. Therefore, the value of n here is 3 by 2. 1 by 2 into the entire integral value became gamma n. Gamma n, that means gamma 3 by 2. 1 by 2, gamma 3 by 2. We don't know the value of gamma 3 by 2. We have seen the value of gamma 1 by 2. What is gamma 1 by 2? Gamma 1 by 2 is equal to root pi. We got the derivation. So we don't know the value of gamma 3 by 2, but we know the gamma 1 by 2. Therefore, 3 by 2 can be written as 1 by 2 plus 1. 1 by 2 plus 1. But 1 by 2, in place of 3 by 2, I wrote 1 by 2 plus 1. We have gamma n is equal to n minus 1, gamma n minus 1. If in place of n you have n plus 1, that will be like this. Gamma n plus 1 is equal to n gamma n. Gamma n is n minus 1, gamma n minus 1. Gamma n plus 1 will be n gamma n. So, in place of n you have 1 by 2. This is gamma 1 by 2 plus 1. Compare with this. Gamma n plus 1 is n gamma n. Therefore, gamma 1 by 2 plus 1 is 1 by 2 gamma 1 by 2. As gamma n plus 1 is n gamma n. This is 1 by 2 gamma 1 by 2. Already we have 1 by 2. And the value of gamma 1 by 2 plus 1 is 1 by 2 gamma 1 by 2. Therefore, 1 by 4 into, as we know, the value of gamma half is root pi. This is 1 by 4 into root pi r root pi by 4. Right? Let us see some more problems. Okay, students, we have been evaluating some problems, some integrals by using gamma function. We have seen two or three problems, and now some more problems. Let us see this problem. Evaluate integral 0 to infinity root x e to the power of minus x cube dx. In the previous problem, you have e power minus x square dx. So we have taken substitution for x square. Why? Because we need e power z, e power minus z, or e power minus t, or e power minus x, e power minus y, like that. So this should be substituted. So replace x cube with t. Put x cube is equal to t. X is equal to t power 1 by 3. Dx is equal to 1 by 3 t power 1 by 3 minus 1 dt. That is, dx is 1 by 3 t to the power of minus 2 by 3 dt. Let us see the limits. As x tends to 0, x cube is equal to t. And when x tends to 0, t tends to 0. When x is infinity, t is also infinity. Therefore, x tends to 0, t tends to 0. As x is infinity, t is also infinity. Therefore, limits will not change. The integral value become integral 0 to infinity, same limits. Root of x. In place of x, what you have? T power 1 by 3. Root of t power 1 by 3. E to the power of minus x cube. In place of x cube, we have t. E to the power of minus t. And dx is 1 by 3. T to the power of minus 2 by 3 dt. Simplified which? 1 by 3 into integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus t, and this is root of t power 1 by 3, nothing but t power 1 by 3 whole to the power of 1 by 2, so t to the power of 1 by 6. This is t power 1 by 6, t power minus t into t power 1 by 6, already t to the power of minus 2 by 3 is there. 1 by 3 is taken out. 1 by 3 integral 0 to infinity e power minus t to the power of 1 by 6 and t to the power of minus 2 by 3 dt. Simplify these two. T to the power of 1 by 6 t to the power of minus 2 by 3. 1 by 6 minus 2 by 3 is LCM 6, 1 minus 4. Minus 3 by 6, that is minus 1 by 2. So t to the power of 1 by 6 into t to the power of minus 2 by 3 became t to the power of minus 1 by 2. The integral value is 1 by 3 integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus t into t to the power of minus 1 by 2 dt. that is 1 by 3 t equal 0 to infinity to the power of minus t. I wrote minus 1 by t as 1 by 2 minus 1. We should have t power n minus 1 or m minus 1. In that form, we should have e power minus x into x power n minus 1. Therefore, I replaced minus 1 by 2 with 1 by 2 minus 1. Thus, the value of n here is 1 by 2. So, gamma 3 and all this integral value is, this is gamma 1 by 2. N is 1 by 2. Therefore, this integral value is gamma 1 by 2. 1 by 3 into gamma 1 by 2. We know very well about gamma 1 by 2. Gamma 1 by 2 is root 5. So, this is 1 by 3 into root 5. Right? Let's see another problem.